show you a general talk, probably most useful for the students and for all the people, because I have made some considerations in general about the situation of science. This is the outline of the talk, and it is important the use of wisdom in physics, and something wrong in science. I would like to remark something about these topics. This is my institute, Istituto Nazionale di Astrofisica, Istituto di Astrofisica e Planetologia Spaziale. We are involved in many space experiments, and practically we are ranging from the high energy astrophysics to exoplanets measurements with the new satellites that they are building, and some of them already working. Then I belong to the USPID, Unione degli Scienziati per il Disarmo, is a non-profit organization of scientists and researchers founded in 1982. And the objective is to provide information and analysis to the public and institution in the field of arms and disarmament control, including information on environmental impact and the costs human beings following development and the dissemination of weapons. The profound respect of human nature is the spring that pushes the members of the USPID to undertake a journey that is a harbinger of the universal peace. And among them, there are agnostic, atheists, religious of all creeds, but who have in common the strong determination to work for a better world, free from the danger of the total destruction that they are very close to this, in my opinion. This is the history of the chicken's blood. In the time of Fermi, when they are working in Los Alamos for preparing the atomic bomb, and Enrico Fermi said willing to use the blood of a chicken, named the atomic bomb, to counter the Nazi threat. On the other hand, Franco Rosetti, that is not willing to use chicken blood, the atomic bomb, even to counter the hated Nazi threat. Franco Rosetti has an absolute ethical vision. Weapons of mass destruction are evil and cannot even be constructed as the deterrent against that other absolute evil that is Nazism. Scientists have a special social responsibility. They cannot work for evil, they cannot sell the soul to the evil, they cannot use chicken blood even to get the best result possible. There is a growing awareness that human beings must have absolute priority, and that human growth is much more important than economic growth. We started to become aware that in our modern societies, oriented towards information and characterized by a huge flow of knowledge, there must be an equally great flow of wisdom that allows use to appropriate knowledge, a wisdom that provides to the individual and to the society a direction and precise objectives. Scientific developments alone cannot bring happiness, nor can socialism or capitalism. There is something wrong in this historical moment. It does not matter how many conferences you make, how much emphasis on ethics, how many lessons in psychology or philosophy should be held. Something essential is missing. The great ideal of the 20th century, communism and capitalism. Communism was distributing the wealth that they did not produce. Capitalism produces wealth that does not distribute. This is very... Antoine de Saint-Exupéry, in a sense, Alavir writes, "We must understand that somewhere along our path we have taken the wrong way. Today humanity as a whole is richer than it ever was. We enjoy abundance and ease never before achieved. However, we lack something indefinable, but basic, the feeling of ourselves as human beings is becoming more and more rarefied. We lost something that was one of our mysterious prerogatives. This is an important topic. Humanity is in a wrong way. All human efforts are inspired by the attempt to answer this question. Where do we come from? Where are we going? Why we are here? And this was also written by Lev Nikolaevich Tolstoy when Anna Karenina was speaking with Levin. You will begin to ask yourself who we are, where do we go, where do we come from? And also Paul Gauguin painted these wonderful paintings which is in the Museum of the Fine Arts in Boston, and the figures present humanity in the different states of life from infancy to the old age in a mysterious and indeterminate nature. Many people claim that the prevailing mood nowadays is a feeling of impotence, because everybody says, what I can do in this situation? The individual seems to have no influence on political, economic, and environmental decisions. After all, what can you do in the face of the most powerful institution to manage our world? But the sense of impotence only feeds a vicious circle that aggravates the state of things and reinforces that sense of futility felt by common people. Each of us can do something, even small. Science, in all its specialization, searches to explain the morphology and the behavior of the universe, but cannot answer to the three former fundamental questions. People search for a better way to live, and one spiritual tool for it is the compassion. Please, may I have 100 grams of compassion? Sorry, sir, you cannot find compassion in this shop of delicatessen. Compassion is solidarity of the earth. Compassion is often thought as akin to pity, but whereas pity may be condescending, compassion springs from a sense of the equality and the interconnectedness of life. Genuine compassion is about empowering others, helping them unlock strength and the courage from within their lives in order to overcome their problems. Nichiren and Daishonin established the practice of chanting Nam-myoho-renge-kyo as a practical means for people to bring forth the strength and the rich potential of their humanity and live with confidence and joy. Sharing this practice with the others is therefore the most essential act of compassion for practitioners of Nichiren Daishonin. For having compassion, you must make your human revolution. The human revolution of a single individual will contribute to the change of the destiny of the nation and will eventually lead to a change in the destiny of all humanity. And we have several big examples of it: Mahatma Gandhi, Nelson Mandela, Martin Luther King, Vahagari Maathai, Mother Teresa of Calcutta, and others. They demonstrate with their life that it's possible to change the history of one nation and of the world. Daisaku Ikeda explained, there are various types of revolutions: political, economic, industrial, scientific, artistic, but regardless of what is changed, the world will never be better until people remain selfish and devoid of compassion. In this sense, the human revolution is the most important of all revolutions and at the same time the most necessary for humanity. This is the unique way, in my opinion, to go on. The Soka Gakkai International is a Buddhist in action for peace and empowering individuals toward positive global change. So these are my three institutions into which I belong. Our universe. A part of the talk I'm going to present now is coming from this book dated 2004, so it is a bit old now, but it made a complete vision of the world in that time, and updating this book is always sufficient for making good point of the situation in the knowledge of our universe. The content of universe, we have a total limited amount of power in the universe that is given by this formula, which gives this enormous power, 10 to 59 ergs. For people not familiar with this number, means 10 with the 59 zero after. Therefore, the universe is permeated with energy in a continuous exchange with the matter. Through the formula, well-known formula of Einstein, energy is equal to mass multiplied by the square power of velocity of light. Therefore, the universe is a living being because we have continuously the exchange between energy and matter. We are here, we are a particular small piece of the universe in this moment. The composition of the universe. We know only practically 5% of the universe, and not very well. Ordinary matter 4.4%, neutrinos 0.6%, dark matter 22%, and dark energy 73%. These two parts practically are almost completely unknown. Therefore, we know only roughly 5% of the universe, and not very well. Now, with the advent of the detection of the gravitational waves, we start to have a bit more information about all our universe. And this is a big moment for the physics and for the humanity, because we have definitively demonstrated that the general theory of relativity of Einstein is completely valid. How to know our universe? What is now the situation about the universe? As I said, we know roughly 5% of the universe, and not very well. However, with the big experiments, space and the ground-based, and the multitude of small experiments, space-based experiments, with the small, mini, micro, nano, and the cube satellites, and the ground-based experiments, small telescopes, and the robotic telescopes, we are going to know better the compositions and the laws of governing our universe. But for this purpose, is much better the use of wisdom, besides, of course, the knowledge of the physics. We have definitively one bridge between the Big Bang and biology, because the universe, independent of the origin, was starting its life, and we are here. Therefore, we have a bridge between the Big Bang and the biology. How to cross this bridge? What are the experimental tools for understanding the pillars of this bridge? In order to cross this bridge, as always when we cross a bridge, we must advance slowly, step by step, with the continuity, because everything is smoothly linked in the magma of the universe. Sorry. From the infinitely small to infinitely big. This is a very beautiful picture made by Sir Martin Rees many years ago, and this is the unification between the very small universe to the big to the very big universe. Therefore, the ultimate unification will involve quantum gravity, the Planck scale, and the cosmology. And we lack the theories to connect the gravitation with the quantum physics. Therefore, we are still making many attempts to arrive to this point. But for instance, we have produced a multitude of so-called elementary particles. They are order of 200, in my opinion, means that they are not elementary, because to be elementary should be 2, 3, 4, 5, not 200. Therefore, we have to explore and to understand what is the origin really of the matter. This is a picture taken by the book of Pierluigi and De Capra, The System View of Life. If we take a section of metabolic, a simple bacterium, we have that each point, means each chemical compound, is connected to any other point through the complexity of the network. And if we take the cosmic network, also here we have that each point is connected to any other point through the complexity of the network. If we take the human body, taken also by the book before mentioned, we have a link between all the organs of the body. And this is also valid for the human society. We have our society interconnected with many things, like poverty, democracy, destabilization, immigration, etc., etc. So each point is connected to any other point through the complexity of the network. All these people belong to the humanity. They follow the cycle: birth, growth, aging, death. And also the components of the universe follow the same cycle: birth, growth, aging, death, and as the living beings. Therefore, for a complete understanding of the history of the universe, it is necessary to search along that cycle. For this purpose is mandatory the use of wisdom in physics, and not only in physics. We can't solve the problem by using the same kind of thinking we used when we created them, said Einstein. And I add, we can attack each kind of problem in a way as general as possible, and in any case it is necessary to go on without blinkers. This is important. Accretion process regulates, the accretion regulates the growth and evolution of all objects in the universe, from young stellar objects, white dwarfs, neutron stars and black holes, active galactic nuclei, protoplanetary disks, planetary bombardment. So the accretion is a general process occurring in the universe. And this is a picture we used in one of our conferences just to show what means the accretion. No? People are dancing, and after the dance, the mass is going to the man, and the lady is losing mass. In the case of binary systems, we have the so-called low-mass binary systems or high-mass binary systems. Low and high depends on the mass of the optical companion of the binary systems. And we have also the so-called cataclysmic variables, compound by one starts roughly with the temperature of order of 3-4,000 Kelvin, so with the temperature lower than the sun, and a white dwarf as compact objects. Therefore, if we take, for instance, the behavior, the optical behavior of the classical novae, the so-called dwarf novae, so-called Zetacam objects, and SU UMA types, means different kind of cataclysmic variables, we can have an analogy very interesting like this. And apparently they are different, but all of them belong to the same human species, like that all the cataclysmic variables are cataclysmic variables. Therefore, it is necessary to find the method as general as possible to describe the behavior of cataclysmic variable. This can be obtained looking at the accretion behavior and the magnetic field. But the nature, in all its manifestations, show continuity. Then we have to abandon the convenient method of thinking everything in watertight compartments and go toward a general model for compact accreting stars. And this was made by Lipunov, Vladimir Lipunov, many years ago. He considered a gravimagnetic rotator with the rotational velocity omega and with the magnetic moment mu, and using a parameter that he called the gravimagnetic parameter, given by the accretion rate of mass into the compact object, divided by the square root, the square of magnetic moment, all these objects lie in the plane. P spin means rotational period and gravimagnetic parameter. So this is a general, real general method to understand the behavior of the gravimagnetic rotators. The use of wisdom in physics. I have many examples, but I would like to give few words. The correct procedure in passive physics is to observe and collect experimental data, to analyze this data without any a priori bias, to attempt their interpretation on the base of current models. If not possible, it is mandatory to search for other models that cannot be ad hoc. This seems trivial, but unfortunately it is not so. And with a good small quantity of wisdom, I can give one example of a synergy between history and the physics. Bernd Aschenbach is a German expert of supernova remnants. The supernova remnants are the remnants that are present after the explosion of the supernova. The supernova explodes and the matter starts to move in the surrounding space, and then with the formulae of set determined in end of 30 years to study the explosions, nuclear explosion, 40 years, sorry, to study the explosion of a nuclear bomb. They were used also for explaining the expansion of the supernova. And Bernd Aschenbach made variations in the formula of Sedov and used as test the supernova Vela Junior, and they found an age of 725 years, contrary to the age determined with the Sedov formula. He found an historical document, Tatsunokuchi Persecution of Nichiren Daishonin, the Buddha of the Last Day of the Law, that supported these results with exceptional precision. The date of explosion was 12 September 1271, at 1 hour plus minus 2 hours. Why this? Because Nichiren Daishonin was persecuted and sentenced to death. Therefore, the night when he was going for the execution, suddenly when he was ready to cut the head, suddenly appeared a light very intense in the horizon of the place, and the event culminated at 10 degrees above the horizon with the celestial declination minus 46, which is the position of the Vela Junior, and the light was like a moon, a full moon, which is compatible with the supernova of type 1A. This is not important. Therefore, the document for the first time gave the exact date and hour of explosion of a supernova. Therefore, this datum is very important for making the recalibration of all supernovae. So it's better to look at the literature also without without thinking only to the physics or only to the chemistry, etc., etc. Something wrong in science. Number of publications, independent of their real value, determines the value of a researcher. This provokes the hunt to more and more articles. This is valid in all the field of science. The number of citation determines the value of a paper. This provokes friendly chains of citation. Publication. To complete a research article, you need at least 3 months of a fully dedicated time once you have collected all the data, etc. Therefore, you have a per limit of publication yearly order of 4, plus 6 publications in international conferences. The total number of publications should be 10 plus minus 3. How can some colleagues publish more than 100 articles per year? Because we have many examples of this. So if we take a very interesting graph, in the red we have the total papers produced, and in blue the population in astronomy research. Therefore, we see that more or less we are going roughly at the same level. Papers are increasing with the increasing population, but the papers for member in astronomy is in the last century until roughly beginning of the in 19th century and the beginning of the 20th century, we had more or less 3-4 publication, 2-3-4 publication for each person. Now we stay at 0.3 publication for each researcher. So this means that this system doesn't work. Many papers never get cited. 50% of all science papers get less than one citation. 27% of papers in natural science get zero citation. In astronomy, 6% never cited after 18 years, and 3.3% never cited after 4 years. So this means that these publications are not useful at all. And this is coming from the fact that people are searching to publish for getting the renewal of the position, etc., etc. New facilities. We have a lot of new facilities that produce a lot of data, and we are waiting roughly 200 petabyte expected up to 4.6 exabyte. So are we ready for handling this amount of data? How will it be possible to arrive at the synthesis? Thanks to the numerous experiments ground space-based, we have collected a huge amount of experimental data, the use of which is extremely difficult. This greatly limits the possibility of reaching a synthesis. In contrast, this immense amount of data generates a production of thousands of scientific articles that only in few cases lead to a real advances of knowledge. And this is an example of fundamental papers without pretension of completeness. Baden-Swiecki first suggested that the supernova was the result of the transition from a normal star to a neutral star, and the essential point being that the energy release in gravitational potential energy of the star, which collapses from its normal size of order 10 to 6 km down to the size of a neutral star of order 10 km. Therefore, the discovery of the first X-ray source, COX-1, by Giacconi, Gursky, Paolini and Rossi, accelerated the studies of neutral star until that Zeldovich and Gusainov suggested the presence of an unseen massive companion in a binary system. This is the discovery, almost by chance, of the COX-1, because the experiment made with the rocket was projected, was designed to look at the X-ray emission in the moon, but they used a very wide field of view, therefore they by chance measured the presence of an extra solar X-ray source named COX-1. This paper gave rise to the 2002 Nobel Prize of Riccardo Giacconi. These are the fundamental paper about the collapsed star in binary systems. This is a fundamental paper about the emission from a neutral star. This is the fundamental paper of Nikolai Shakura that for the first time introduced the alpha parametrization. It means that in the accretion disk that we said before, the accretion disk is viscous, and this is a parameter that gives a measure of the viscosity. And this is a fundamental paper that received more than 9,000 citations in the literature. Okay, gamma ray burst was discovered by chance. Gamma ray burst, they were discovered by the USA Vela satellites that were actually built to detect the gamma radiation pulses emitted by nuclear weapons tested in space. Why? Well, the USA suspected that the Soviet Union might attempt to conduct secret nuclear tests after signing the Nuclear Test Ban Treaty in 1963. So they measured by chance with these two satellites that were separated after the launches, Vela A and Vela B, and they discovered a very bright gamma ray emission with duration of order of few seconds, but very, very bright, and these were named gamma ray burst. But their origin was unknown until that Paczynski in 86 suggested the possible cosmological origin at redshift about 1.2. And after more than 10 years, in 97, the measurement made by Pepo Sachs satellite, they measured the light of the gamma ray burst and the afterglow after few minutes, etc. So therefore, this was the first measurements that demonstrated the cosmological origin of gamma ray burst. Okay, so conclusion reflection, we have difficulties in making simultaneous multi-frequency, multi-site, multi-instrument, multi-platform measurements due to objective technological difficulty, sharing common scientific objects, problems of scheduling, the budgets, and the political management of science. I will jump the political management of science because I have no time. Anyway, one word I can say, an example, I proposed the Spanish-Italian X-ray experiment, SIXE. It was a multi-frequency X-ray optical payload for long-term continuous observations, few selected sources, and we made, with the budget coming from Spain, the phase A study, means that practically the preparation to go on with the preparation of the payload, and I presented to the Italian Space Agency this project, and no answer at all, neither no. No answer. So this means political Management of Science. Okay. Why do we need the space experiment? We need the space experiment because the atmosphere is blocking the emission in gamma rays, X-rays, ultraviolet, infrared, etc. Only few ranges are available from the for the observation from the ground. Okay. We have two classes of physics experiments, active physics experiments, and with this it was measured the presence of the Higgs boson, and I would like to passive physics experiments that are ground and space-based, in which we observe the nature, and these are future experiments, extremely large European telescope, and this is the James Webb Space Telescope, which is the new version, much more sensitive with respect to the Hubble Space Telescope. And Gaia, it is working and is measuring the position of billion of stars. So means that we can have the distance, real distance of stars, and then we can know the energetic of these stars. Okay, so with all passive and active physics experiments, we are going toward the knowledge of the universe. General relativity has been proven because the gravitational lenses have been observed with the Hubble Space Telescope. Gravitational waves have been measured, and they measured the merging of two black holes of 36 solar masses, 29 solar masses, and the black hole of 62 solar masses was formed, and a lot of energy was coming out in the form of gravitational waves. And this was the reason because these people get the Nobel Prize in Physics in 2017. In August 17, 2017, it was measured the fusion of two neutron stars. And it is important measurements, one of the most important measurements of this epoch. But people forget to mention the paper of Lipunov et al. In 95 that predicted the neutron star merge just at the distance practically to which they measured really this merging. And they, together with the gravitational wave from the neutron star merging, it was detected also a gamma ray burst, and also in this case it was predicted by Mr. Lipunov et al. In this paper 95, so means several years before. So people forget typically the original papers. This is the reason because I'm touching this problem. Okay, this news result of the that everybody have seen in the newspaper. They measured a black hole in the center of the galaxy M87 with the mass of 6.5 in 10 to 9 solar mass. Means 6.5 billions of solar masses. And this is just an experimental result supporting again better the general theory of relativity of Einstein. So all the people say that the Big Bang exists, but I would like to say that we are in agreement after few moments with respect to the supposed explosion. So therefore, there is a theory that says that after the explosion, after few moments at 10 to minus 36 seconds, we had the inflation. This means that the universe suddenly expanded expanded from the dimension of a 6 millimeter to these kilometers, okay? In order to say that the inflection really exists, it is necessary to prove, and we have one signature that can be measured, means the polarization of the cosmic background that we have in the universe. Cosmic background is the remnant of the supposed Big Bang explosion. Is a cosmic background at 2.7 degrees that permeates all the space. So if we measure the polarization of this cosmic microwave background, means that the hypothesis of the inflation is okay. But BICEP 2 telescope placed in South Pole in 2014 claimed the detection of this polarization with the very high statistical significance. Therefore, they said, okay, we have demonstrated that the inflection exists. But another group looked at the same direction where they measured from South Pole, and they found the presence of dust that simulate exactly the same results that the first investigator claimed. Therefore, it is necessary to be careful. There is a group that suggests that the origin of the universe is not the Big Bang, but could be a bouncing universe that does not need the inflation. So it's sort of a membrane universe that clashed endlessly. This is a striking suggestion, should be in agreement with the cycle, birth, growth, aging and death. Therefore, for this reason, is even more important to find an experimental proof of the inflection, because we cannot have any parameter to be measured for the clash of the universes. Therefore, it is important to measure the presence of the polarization in order to say that after the Big Bang we had really the inflection. This is one of the most warm points in this moment. How to arrive to the other side of the bridge between the Big Bang and biology, planetary system formation, planets formations. We have the Kepler observatory that measured a lot of new exoplanets, and we have more than 4,000 exoplanets confirmed. Therefore, we have also an important information that the water present in the original nebula before the formation of a solar system was containing water. Therefore, the water we have in our solar system is coming from the original nebula. This means that since this is only one of the millions, billions systems like a solar system, means that the water is present in everywhere in the universe. Therefore, we are going now to search for planets in the so-called habitable zone. Habitable zone means not very close to the star like Mercury or Venus, or not very far because it's too cold, like Jupiter, Saturn, etc., etc. So that we have found, for instance, these planets that is the most Earth-like planet ever discovered, and could be home of alien life. The temperature is just right for liquid water to flow. This means that we are optimist in searching for this kind of exoplanets. If we look at the field of view of Kepler, they measured up to 3,000 light years. Therefore, taking the exoplanet definitively detected by Kepler, and they found at 13 April 2018, 30 planets like Earth, we can make an extrapolation among which 30 are Earth size. In the habitable zone of the galaxy, we can expect at least 3,000 Earth-sized planets. But this is a real very low limit, because now we know that practically all the stars have planets around, two or three planets around. This means that since we have order of 100, 200 billions of stars in the galaxy, we can have 4 or 5 billions of planets in our galaxy. Two wise free thinkers affirmed at the distance of 2,200 years that Siddhartha exposes a grandiose vision of the universe through the concept of major systems of worlds, a concept on a huge scale that implies both the existence of countless galaxies and the possibility of sentient life on other planets than other than our own. And in the 17th century, Giordano Bruno wrote dell'infinito universo et mondi, in which he says that we can have a lot of worlds with the possibility of life outside of the solar system. And of course we must wait scientific confirmation for the alien life, we must wait even more for the discovery of intelligent life, but the number of detected planets is growing very fast. As I said, we expect 400, 500 billion planets in our galaxies, and we have 1,000 billion galaxies in the universe. Thus, we can reasonably affirm that the universe is full of life, hoping to avoid to be burned alive. Formation condition of developing of life. Okay, I will jump this, but I would like the what intelligent humanity has done and what it is doing, because this is very, very important. I need 5 minutes more or less. In the past, this is a typical club. The violent clashes between small communities of hunter-gatherers in conflict for the resources are not rare events in the Paleolithic or in the Neolithic, although it is difficult to speak of real wars because of the restricted numbers of individuals that constituted the typical community group of the Stone Age. And this is the witness of the first massacre. People found 27 people, including 6 children, and each skeleton so far brought to light shows obvious sign of blunt force trauma. So this probably is the first documented massacre. And this is another massacre 2,000 years later. Therefore, if we took at the population of the planet from the 10,000 years before Christ up to now, we know that we see that until practically 1950 we had roughly 1 billion of inhabitants in the planet, and then we grow up to now we are almost at 8 billion of people in the Earth. So this is the growth of world population, very beautiful picture made by Robert Fogel, Nobel Prize in Economics in 1993, in which he point all the principal point with the discoveries and with the advancement of the humanity. But I have found a very important relationship that people dead in wars follow exactly the curve of the growth of the world population. So the last news we had is the Second World War, with the almost 85 millions of people dead, this means that we will have a new war without nuclear weapons, because with the nuclear weapons it is always all is finished. We can have an order of half a billion dead in the war. So Europe and the Mediterranean areas, the cradle of civilization and the wars. These are all the wars from 200 years before Christ up to now, and you can see practically Europe and the Mediterranean area are the main producers of the war in the world. And some important discoveries. We had an accidental discovery, the penicillin, made by Sir Alexander Fleming, but this is obvious a big advancement in the history of the humanity, but the penicillin is not for everybody. Then the discovery of America, made by Cristoforo Colombo, was made by chance, because he was looking for arriving to India, and therefore it was not able to recognize, on the contrary, another continent that was discovered by Amerigo Vespucci. But this discovery happened by chance, and we had the massacre of the native population, first by Spanish, then by British. The end of December 38, we had the discovery of the fission of the uranium 235, because these two chemists, Otto Hahn and Fritz Strassmann, they proved experimentally that the uranium nucleus, if it absorbs a neutron, can be divided in two or more fragments, that and thus giving rise to nuclear fission. But they were searching for transuranic elements. Therefore, the fission was discovered by chance again. And the enormous quantity of energy coming from the fission immediately was used for preparing the atomic bomb. The gadget was experimental on July 1645 in the Operation Trinity, and the first atomic bomb, nicknamed Little Boy, in Hiroshima, and the Fat Man. Therefore, we started with a very beautiful dance of nuclear weapons, and we put the sword of Damocles on the head of humanity and of all life forms. This year, it was found in the beaches of Hiroshima some vitrified microparticles that are coming from the explosion of the 45. These microparticles are the same found in the zone where that destroyed the life of the dinosaurs. Asteroid, grazie. The asteroid. The big asteroid. In that zone, we have also the same kind of vitrified microparticles. Then, this is very interesting news. From 45 to 98, we had in our planets 2,053 nuclear explosions made by mainly by USA, 1,032, Soviet Union, 732, and the other. So, this is the... You can imagine how is the pollution, nuclear pollution we have in our planet. So we can search for the reason why we have a lot of cancers in the humanity, etc., etc. Okay, the absurdity is that the security is based on mutual guarantee destruction. We spent 1,007 billion dollars for a year. With only 4% of this amount, we can eliminate the hunger in the world, the endemic diseases, including AIDS, and the education of for all the children in the world. It is possible to arrive to nuclear disarmament because at the end of the Cold War we had 70,000 nuclear devices. Now we have only 16,000, and because of the agreements, so the zero target is probably possible. It is necessary to make the result permanent, to transform the human spirit for a world free from a nuclear weapon. Okay, so I think that we have to say that the other things are all connected with the poverty. For instance, in South Africa, now we have the most discrepancy between the inequality of distribution of richness versus the quality of life, Brazil, USA, etc. And the first transplant of heart in South Africa is important, of course, advancement in medicine, but give rise to the commerce of organ, traffic of organs that illegally is coming from the poor countries, and we take organs from the poor boys to give new organs to the rich boys. So the average age is strictly proportional to the quantity of energy available per person. Means that in Africa the average age is 40 years, and in our country is 8 years, because we have three order of magnitude more of energy. So okay, I will stop here. Thank you.
Franco.
I'm sorry for the time.
I'm sorry that we have no time. Yeah. Actually, we should have more time. We should find a way to have more time, generally. Yeah. Anyway, we really have 5 minutes for a coffee, because at 1 o'clock we have the lunch. At